What's going on, guys? It's Deathmonk here. Welcome to another episode of WWE 2K22 My Rise. In the last episode, what you may have noticed is basically had our very first match against one of the heels in this game. So I'm going to be continuing on from where we left off pretty much in the last episode, and looks like we're going to have to challenge Paragon JPers. And
before you say anything, do you really think you just got everything I had? It's obvious I shouldn't be here. So I'm not going to give 100% in a training match against a nobody.
Ooh. You think you just got everything I had? You're right. You
shouldn't be here. About one thing. You shouldn't be here. Not because you deserve to be in WWE, but because you're an overhyped, undermotivated egomaniac who's full of excuses.
Face me when it really counts, and we'll see what happens.
I'd like to, but if you keep losing training matches to nobodies, then I'll never get the chance.
Got him there. Okay. Okay, this one should be really interesting, I feel. Okay, some stuff is a second. Now, the dog. Just trying to see if I can find a way to. Oh, options menu, hang on a minute. Yeah. Options. Just need to check something. Okay. Now, do we have an option where we can change the actual audio settings? Doesn't look like we do, so.
Hey, big news! We got another member of DX coming to help out for a bit at the PC.
Okay. Hornswoggle?
No. One of the members of the best version of DX, X-Pac.
Cool.
You know, I have to agree that the DX you were a part of was the best one.
Damn straight it was. But you know who disagrees? Shawn Michaels.
You guys took what they started and made it 10 times better.
That's what I always say. Anyway, what if when X-Pac is here, we had a match to settle this debate? You, me, and X-Pac against Shawn, Hector, and Chase.
Sounds awesome.
That sounds awesome. And if we win, I get to be an honorary member of DX?
Let's not go crazy.
Okay, storyline confirmation. This is storyline confirmation prompt. I'll give you information on the storyline, including the potential rewards gained on completing and always having the opportunity to confirm or back out of a storyline through this prompt. If you decide to confirm, you'll be locked into a storyline and no longer explore to different locations until you finish it. Like, if you want to explore a mobile bar, customize to WWE Super Circuit, now select to decline the story and come back to it. Yes. Okay, it is easy to pin and submit opponents when they have lower health and have been hit by powerful moves like finishers. If your superstars have finisher stock available, the announce table finisher assigned to a and create a moveset, start with an X near the announce button to perform it. And stuck in a combo, predict your opponent's next move and match the button, square, circle, X, before the attack lands. If you guess correctly, you interrupt the combo and punish them. Okay. Slowly to catch it down and go into your finisher. When your opponent is in the air, press R2 and X to perform a catch and finisher. Right, just before I do this any further, I just wanted to quickly change option here. Would that mean presentation? No. Is it gameplay options? Presentation options. I'm looking for. Okay, whatever. Okay, match rules. Okay. Wait a minute, Sean. Yeah. These dependents submit pawns when they have lower health and have been hit by powerful moves like finishes. Okay. Options menu. Okay. Oh, okay. Social media. So let's have a look here. Thanks for the invite to the bomb stock for Jogger Verbs. Thanks for writing the PC World Jogger. I'm always happy to pass my legends. Next gen, happy to still pass my first on Shawn Michaels. Okay, DMs. Optional extra good homework network assignment for you if you're interested. False checking, picking up dry cleaning or washing your car, not interested. Now, Chase, I want to advantage of all that. I want you to study WWE Legends matches. You can learn a lot by just watching the greats. Accepted. Izzy, who do you have in mind? That's up to you, but whoever you choose, don't just watch their matches. I want you to visualize first them in the ring and what it would take to complete on their level. Let me know who you pick. Ooh. Bret Hart. So I'll try it. Let me know how it goes. Okay. Interesting. Okay, so I'm to learn as much as I can. Okay, but that's a different move which doesn't require lifting. Okay. These defenders submit opponents when they have low health and been hit by powerful moves like finishers. Superstars finishers stock available. Yada yada yada.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Newcastle upon Tyne, England, weighing in at 244 pounds, Elliot Dunn.
While this competitor was on the indies, he crossed paths with some future WWE superstars, but he must know this is a completely different animal.
And he's on a different level now, but the only way to prove that is by stringing victories together. Time match for the Hitman.
And his opponent, representing the Hart Foundation, from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 235 pounds, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Saxton, you should be standing up and applauding that the Hitman has graced us with his presence.
Corey, can you believe that Bret Hart made his pay-per-view debut at WrestleMania 2?
Of course I can believe it. I can believe that Bret Hart's a national hero, whereas you, Byron, aren't even a hero in your own house.
You don't know that.
This superstar is coming in with a lot of enthusiasm and energy right now.
But what's going to happen when the excitement wears off and he comes to realize he's in a fight against someone who's going to take his head off?
All I can say is we've seen adrenaline take this superstar very far in the past.
We got Canada's favorite son on the other side. There's no question Hart's an elite strategist, but will the Hitman be able to carry out his plan as he devised it? Or is he going to have to make adjustments during the course of the match?
I seriously doubt Bret is having
high risk. Feet with an elbow drop. He goes for the quick pin attempt. The Hitman kicks out.
He might have been putting the cart before the horse with that pin, but it was worth a try.
And landing with the double axe handle.
Hart just can't stop this attack.
The Hitman is showing some vulnerabilities in his game. Elbow drop.
Pulling him in for the pole breaker.
Right to the lower back.
He's going for it all. He's got him in the crosshairs.
Incoming!
He has a task at hand, but prefers to be showboating right now. Retaliation from the Hitman.
Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire.
And now he's really falling behind.
This is where his fortitude will be put to the test.
Saw that one coming.
Big knee to the midsection. And landing with the double axe handle.
Ooh, a planted knee.
Ouch.
Double leg takedown. Step through looking for a submission here. Legs are locked up. Uh-oh. Oh. Face first. He turns it around. Golly, this. Is it enough, guys? Is it? And gets met with a huge roadblock right there.
Brett was waiting for it.
Big boy. Into the turnbuckle.
And Brett gets countered.
Oh, chin-breaking uppercut.
He was elusive there.
Reversal on top of reversal.
What a clothesline. Hart is being stifled in this one. The Hitman unable to...
Going for it.
Cross-face submission is in.
The lights are dimming for the Hitman.
No, he lets him out.
Yeah, I think he knew he wasn't going to get the submission there.
He's dictating the pace of this match now, guys. He's got that determined look now.
High risk.
Looking for the victory.
Two. Absolute power.
That sucked all the air out of this place. It looked like a done deal.
Staggering to his feet, but he won't like what's coming next. Hart wasting no motion on the counter. Reciprocating the initial reversal.
The superstar building and...
Had to get it going, but gets stonewalled.
He could pin his opponent right here.
It's over.
Two.
He clearly wants to dish out more punishment. But why not get the pinfall first?
The uppercut.
That'll cost some teeth. He's in a bad way, guys.
This is a very dangerous situation now.
We've seen Bret Hart make some big comebacks before, and he'll need to do it again.
A miracle.
Able to get out of the way.
This just right for him.
Hart gets out of there.
Turning the tables there.
Oh, the arm's trapped.
Oh, a slam.
Can't quite get him there.
never saw that coming.
Into the corner he goes, a perfectly placed target. Oh, an arm wringing shoulder breaker.
Oh, and soon we could be seeing a submission here. There he is.
Will this match end on a win? Tony Bennett tap out.
Unbelievable. This singles match is over.
Here is your winner, Elliott Dunn.
And nothing to scoff at with that win, gentlemen. They got it done.
Looks like Brett's opponent was even better than the best there ever will be.
Nice. Just letting you know, my homework is out. I would hope you wouldn't lose a match in your own imagination, but nonetheless, it's stuck on some extra credit. It'll be a difficult level than double having a single match. What are you thinking? This time you can actually imagine being two of the biggest stars of all time in a handicap match. Not right now. Back. Let's switch feet. Okay. And after this, I think I'll call it an episode. This is how much I hate. On Raw.
The following contest is a handicap match. Making his way to the ring from Newcastle upon Tyne, England, weighing in at 244 pounds, Elliott Dunn.
So much has changed for this superstar since he completed his training with Booker T.
A former indie competitor, he left Houston a new athlete and set course full steam ahead for WWE.
Listen, this is pure electricity. I feel like the entire arena is shaking right now.
It's all thanks to the unmatched power of the Bravo.
And their opponent from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, The Rock.
Well, here's a man who's captured the imagination of the entire sports entertainment industry, the Brahma Bull, one of the very best of all time.
Without question, The Rock has been a champion at every level.
Hey, Saxton, your role? Know it. Your mouth? Shut it.
That wasn't very nice.
Austin marching to the ring, the trademark scowl on his face, ready for business.
A man who just oozes attitude and does whatever he wants.
And his partner from Victoria, Texas, weighing in at 252 pounds, Stone Cold Steve.
I just don't understand why a superstar would accept a match in which they're outnumbered. I mean, confidence is one thing, but recklessness is another.
WWE is reckless, if nothing else, Michael. You should know that by now. Besides, there's usually a good reason to sanction such a match.
I'm not so sure of that in this match, but we'll find out.
floor.
Tapping the leg. DDT. Tearing down the leg now. Boom, impact. He knew that was coming.
An inverted atomic drop.
Very nice.
Ooh, again.
The Rock is laying the smack it down.
The Rock's opponent needs to know his limits.
What are you guys thinking?
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
He's been placed in the corner now. Oh, jaw shattering. Face wash. Taking this match off the mat now.
High risk.
Fake with an elbow drop. Off into the pin. And the referee stops the count before two.
He is certainly sending a message, getting his shoulder up before two.
Stone Cold reverses. Oh, he retaliates. Vicious right forearm. Discouraging situation for the People's Champion.
The Rock is being dominated here.
What grace. Float over to the DDT.
The Rock may be in a bad way here.
Rolls through, shoulders down.
Oh, this has got to be it. Starting to weigh down on him.
Getting up, but doesn't have a clue what's coming at him.
At the top of the diving hammer strike. Counters that.
But Rock has to keep the pedal at full throttle while he has the opening.
Yeah. Oh, what a clothesline.
Forcefully delivered.
It's more.
Ouch. Ooh. Here's a cover.
Could be it.
One, two. Breaks the count.
Getting that shoulder up now is huge.
Double axe handle. He's one step ahead there. Did you hear that impact? Tag made. Oh, and a kick right to the midsection. Stone Cold too slow there.
Sent into the corner.
Landing the uppercut. Boom.
Stay, this could be it.
Oh my God, a small package driver. Two count.
Elbow drop, big time.
Turned that one around. Push.
And tag him as the Rock.
Had it scouted. He got whipped into that corner. Boom, uppercut.
That'll knock you silly.
He thinks he has it.
And they're still in this.
Float over.
DDT!
The Rock has been busted wide open. Look at the look on his opponent's face, Cole. He can't believe it.
Locking arm drag, rolls through pinning combination.
And he is saved by the ropes.
Boy, European uppercut.
It's demoralizing to see The Rock in trouble here.
The Rock is not looking good here.
High risk.
As close to three as you could possibly get without the bell ringing.
Rock sensed that was coming.
Standing drop kick.
Great ups.
And now he's just being pushed around. Just an onrush of offense here.
Oh, knee right to the gut. He can end it here.
He's got him.
He keeps his team in the match.
And landing with the double axe handle.
Trapping their opponent's arm. Crossface submission is in.
The Great forces his opponent to tap out. This handicap match is over.
Here is your winner, Elliot Dunn.
I can't imagine a world in which they're not proud of that win.
Yep, that's what we call a good day at the office.
I'm thinking it definitely changed up my moves as I feel. So what not your thoughts of this? Please let me know in the comments box down below. Hope you guys did enjoy this. If you did, smash the thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Don't forget the notification bell to miss any more videos. And if you want to see more of this My Rise mode here, again, let me know in the comments box down below. Hope you guys are interested in seeing more of this. I just wait until we get ourselves back to the main menu, and okay, that's pretty cool to me. And this is where we're going to leave it for today's episode, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, peace out.